Are you not happy with your size, your weight, your height, your facial features, the way you look? If you are not owning your size, you are stilting your own growth. And I'm going to tell you today how to change that. Hi, my name is Dr. Asel Romanelli, and this is The Potential State. And today we're in Own Your Shit 21. Own your size so you can really grow. So over the past 10 years, I've been wearing a large. Why? Just because through different periods when I was in high school, I tried different fashions of wearing too tight, too big, and I kind of landed on large. Why? I guess that's a size that my dad told me I was. I guess that's the size he wore. And his saying was, you will grow into it. You will grow into it. And I always wore large, and I never had any thoughts. I never thought about that. Till about a year and a half ago, I realized that actually that's the wrong size. I'm a medium. And it felt very strange at age 40 to realize I've been wearing the wrong side for the past maybe 15 years. And the more I thought about it, the more I realized that was also connected to my state of mind of feeling small, of things being baggy on me, not being completely full. And since I realized that, I changed my whole wardrobe, and now I wear mediums. And everyone made fun of me for, why are you changing your whole wardrobe? But the second I tasted the freedom of owning my own size, I could actually grow much bigger and different on the other dimensions of my life. And I think a lot of times, because we focus on the way we're too big, we're too small, we try to overcompensate in different ways, which I will describe in a second, we're taking away energy from our other growth, from our psychic growth, our emotional growth, our spiritual growth. And I feel like that is a big issue we need to talk about, especially for women. Over the past 2,000 years, or at least a few hundred years, the patriarchy has been brainwashing women to be obsessed with their size, the way they look, how tall they are, skinny or fat they are, and that has moved all of the women's attention to their body instead of their mind, of their beliefs, of their spirituality. We keep telling girls they're cute instead of smart or funny or what have you read. Always about cute and pretty princess. So I think for women, it's especially difficult to own their size, because if we really own our size, we'd have so much energy to do other things. Because at the end of the day, your confidence, your personality, your self-worth, your self-love, your curiosity can only grow when you are not obsessing all the time with your physical size. And I want to give a few examples. So I'm going to describe two large women, large in the sense that they were very, very tall, but they're also full. One was an actress and one was a client. So the actress, growing up very tall from a young age, she was embarrassed by that. She didn't want to take up too much space, so she started hunched over. She started being hunched over, and she was low status, didn't make a lot of eye contact. Refer back to the status episode. And I met her 25 years later, and she was still acting small. She was not owning her size. And she did come to improvisation class because she wanted to become bigger, but only once she could own the fact that she's big could she find true love, could she find her stage, could she find her energy. The other woman who grew up very, very tall became very, very funny and silly and cute because she says that in high school, boys and girls were threatened by her size. So she made herself small. Maybe she wasn't hunched over, but she was always silly and everything was cute and silly. 20 years later, she's single and she's trying to break that mold. She's trying to finally find a way to own her size and also bring out her full personality. The other extreme of that are short women that I meet in workshops, and they overcompensate for their shortness with talking a lot, being very, very loud, as if that's going to compensate for their size. But they're not owning their size, especially the ones that have to wear crazy high heels or else they won't leave the house because they feel too short. I've met short men who become cynical or jabby or sarcastic just to protect themselves because they're overcompensating for what they feel is something that's not masculine. But I want to give three different examples of people that I've met that are owning their size and that's allowing them to go so much further. So I met this grandmother in her 70s, and she is a big woman, but she's not embarrassed of it. And when she takes her grandkids to the pool, she'll wear one piece, and she feels comfortable with that. She's focusing her energy on her mind, on her relationships, on her curiosity, and less about the diet and what's happening and how does she look. She doesn't care about that anymore. So you can say, granted, that she's 70 years old. But I want to give another example of a man, a short man that I know, and he's the first one to say, to make a playful remark about his own height. He's not embarrassed by it. It's not a big issue. It's not a sensitive topic. And the second he's playful around it, we can move on. And his greatness, his grandeur is expressed in the fact that he's owning his size, that he's a short man. And the last example is my wife, Galit, who is a short woman. And even though in high school she wore huge heels, a decade before I met her, she finally went back to flats. She's not trying to be taller than who she is. She is a huge person because all her energy is going to her growth, her spiritual, emotional, psychological, professional growth. And her personality is huge, and her height has never been an issue. Not for me, not for her, not for anybody. So how do you do that? How do you own your size? The first thing you need to realize is, what is your true size? First of all, check on the physical level. Are you wearing clothes that fit you? Are you energetically, is your posture representative of how big you are or how small you are? And then explore the secondary gains, why you've been doing this, why you've been wearing the large instead of the medium, why you've been hunched over all these years. Usually people minimize themselves because they want to be not threatening. They want people to teach them and to like them, so they go smaller. Other people overcompensate by trying to be bigger than who they are because they're inside, they're feeling a lack of power. So they have to belittle others to feel powerful. So if you notice you're actually losing more than you're gaining, then it's time to own your size. The first thing is to look in the mirror, realize that this is what you are right now physically, and just send the energy where you want to grow, where you want to evolve, curious, learn more. And actually, once you focus more on the other things, there's a bigger chance that your physical size will change. Be stronger, more exercise, more sport, because you're not focusing on it all the time. Expect to be judged and ridiculed when you try to own your size. Even for me, as I was changing from a large to medium, everyone was like, why are you doing it? Oh, you're just shopping for things. But actually, I realized that this was my journey. I needed to go back to my own size. So from there, I can really, really grow and expand. So only when you own your true size, that is when you can really grow to your next evolution. My name is Dr. Osel Romanelli, and this was The Potential State. I'll see you next time.